Hi. You are on the channel Court of CG Computer Graphics. This is a Cinema 4D video tutorial for beginners. Here we will cover all the basics of the program. Well, before we start, subscribe to the channel if you are not subscribed. Well, now let's get started. I will open the Cinema 4D program. Cinema's interface is friendlier than other 3D programs. I will be using the Cinema R26 version. In order to change the interface of Cinema R26 to previous versions of Cinema, you need to click on this slider and on the Standard tab. Now we see the interface of the old Cinema. The first window is the Scene View window. If you hold Alt and the left mouse button on the scene will rotate. Alt and right mouse button zoom and Alt and mouse wheel pan. The next window is the Object window. It contains the objects that are in the scene. Attributes window. Here are the object settings. For example, if we create a cube, we will see that the cube settings have appeared, and we can change the cube settings. This is our materials window. This is where we create the material. Double-clicking on it creates a material. Now it can be dragged onto the cube. To see the mesh on the model, you need to go to the display, and there are various settings for the types of objects in the scene. On the left is the icon panel, change model. By pressing here or C on models. Let's turn the parametric cube into a polygonal one. See, the object's icon has changed. But after this manipulation, unable to switch back from polygonal to parametric. Only if you cancel Ctrl Z. After that it switches to polygonal mode. We can change the cube. Icons for changing points, edges and polygons are activated. Now we can change the model. Next comes the mode of changing the position of the axis. This is our object binding. It often happens that the camera has moved in the project. To fix this, we iterate over the default view and frame. The camera is now back to its original position. Manipulation tools. The first is movement. Can be moved. Scale with it, you can reduce or enlarge the object. And rotation can rotate the object the way you like. These are our rendering icons. This icon here means the rendering of this scene. This is the window for drawing the render output. This is the render setting. In this tab you can select a resolution of the render output, add passes and third-party renders. Such as Arnold, Redshift, and Octane. Let's talk about the difference between parametric modeling and polygonal modeling. For example, let's create a pipe object. In parametric modeling, we have settings. You can change its inner radius, outer radius and various settings. I will create a new pipe and change its mode to polygon by pressing C or this icon, then these settings will disappear, but the mode of points, edges and polygons will appear. Now, in order to make such a model and smooth the edges, we need to add additional edges to it. These manipulations take more time. I usually mix these modes. First, I will make all the appropriate settings in the parametric mode to the maximum, and then I will switch to the polygonal one. Next comes the spline mode. We have many different splines. Add any of these, or you can draw your own. They can be made three-dimensional, with the help of extrude. It is extruded from a 2D object into 3D. Now you can customize it. Next, subdivision surface. If you need to smooth an object, it will help you. But don't forget that, when you add a subdivision, the mesh in the model becomes denser. Therefore, before adding a division, you need to prepare and optimize the model. We will talk about other generators in detail in the next lessons. Next, there are MoGraph objects, with which you can create various interesting animations. The next ones are deformers. For example, let's take the bend deformer. It can be used to bend models. For deformers to work, they must be inserted below the model in the hierarchy. There are such deformers as creating rounding, wireframe, splitting, flow around the model. You can experiment with each deformer. When you right-click an object, the following menu appears. These are tags. With the help of tags, we can give models the dynamics of rigid and soft bodies. Interaction of objects. Hide object. For example, I'll add a vibration tag. If we turn on all its settings and start the animation, we will see that the object began to vibrate. If you want to hide an object in the scene. To do this, double-click on the top point near the model until the red color lights up. Now the object has disappeared from the scene. But if you want the object to not be there when rendering, then you need to double-click on the bottom dot to make the red color appear. In the next Cinema 4D tutorials, we'll talk more about modeling, scene creation, and animation. Subscribe to the channel so you don't miss out. Thanks for watching and bye.